is entitled to a bond on these cases.
Well, bail him out, we don't even know who he is. Well, he won't tell us who he is. Who'd be the principal of the mother?
You know, all I know is what they say. Now, I don't know whether he's given his name or not. He's certainly entitled to a bond in any event, I think.
John, the public defender, heard him admit just now that he's not the person whose name he gave, and he's failed to come forward with the correct name.
Well, until we find out who he is, there's no way we can bail him out.
All right.
The mystery man will be kept behind bars before returning to court to enter a plea. Officials say by then they hope to know who he is.
We have an individual. We don't know who he is yet. So it became an information gathering process, and we focused on the car. There was no hair fibers. There were no trace evidence of any kind. But we did identify that it was a stolen vehicle, stolen from nearby the Chi Omega house. I thought, you know, this might be our first potential suspect. So I sent investigators to Pensacola, and we started to learn more about him.
Two people who want most to know who he is are Tallahassee Detective Steve Botterford and Don Patchen. They have now spent several hours quizzing Mr. Mystery about the slayings last month of two Florida State University co-eds from St. Petersburg.
We started investigating and talking to him, asked him if he would talk to us, and he was reluctant. He started playing games.
He's a very careful thinker, and from what I understand, from the men that have been questioning him, he says what he wants to, and he's very careful about how he says it.
For a while, I let him play his games with my investigators until I said, enough. And then it started unraveling.
I was being interrogated by the police in Pensacola.
And I had no way of measuring the scale of 1 to 10, or 1 to 100 even, what time. The traumatic effect on my mind and body was.
Just someone to talk to who wasn't. I needed a friend. I needed somebody close to. I didn't want a cop or an attorney. I was sick and tired of cops. I need somebody there. Somebody to talk to. Somebody to settle me down and to help me get over this reaction out of being back in custody.
He finally identified himself in exchange for a phone call to his girlfriend, Liz.